We're reaching the end of Moore's Law, which means it's not clear that just buying better GPUs or CPUs will lead to increased speed in computational research. So we're looking at other types of emerging technologies, and quantum is one of the more promising. My role is to really understand the landscape of quantum hardware that exists now, where it's going, and the types of algorithms we think will be accelerated. In 10 years, maybe we'll actually have good enough quantum hardware such that if you wanted to do something, say, look at the structure or the energy landscape of some important molecular system, you could do it more efficiently, or look at systems that you can't do on classical computation with quantum resources. You know, it's not just computing, it's research in biology and chemistry and materials that can potentially be accelerated by having access to these better technologies. So I think it touches on a number of different important areas of science. This field's still quite a ways away from being where we have production level quantum computers that are really doing things useful for us. And I think that can be a little bit like scary if you're working in this, but seeing the jumps people are making is quite inspiring. We also hope and anticipate that there are things that people won't even try to do classically now because it's just not possible. Say studying very complicated molecules or materials and really simulating them at scale, that maybe you could do that in the future, things that we haven't even imagined yet because we have these better technologies available. These two different scales of working at the very fundamental level of improving materials, but also thinking about we can do this calculation potentially in the future once all these problems are figured out, that's like a pretty exciting place to be.